Here, we'll go into questions, Steve.
Connor, obviously a big first inning there, and also a lot of two out base hits today, starting with your three run shot there. What'd you hit out, and maybe kind of take us through the emotion after putting up a five spot for Kroger?
I mean, it's big. Two out hits obviously are huge. We've just been saying to our approach, I mean, they threw a lot of fastballs up or down in counts, and we were just saying to it, and good things happened.
Steph?
Dylan, for you and your four hits today, I guess, what was kind of your approach at the plate, and how much are you kind of starting to click as you get, you know, into your freshman year?
Yeah, I feel like early I was just kind of pressing a little bit, trying to be a little too perfect. So just relaxing and, you know, going back to, you know, me, you know, just hit the fastball, you know, hit the fastball and everything else take care of itself.
Robbie?
Connor, this weekend, one of the things y'all did really well was situational hitting, two outs, guys on base did really well today. I mean, what's been the difference for y'all, you think, this weekend, and how well do you feel like this offense is seeing it right now?
Really well. I mean, Coach Lum says to take the crumbs, and I think we're really doing it as a group right now. And, I mean, you're just taking what you're given, and that's what we've been taking advantage of recently, so it's been huge for us.
Steve?
Connor, we sat here last week and talked about the bottom third of this order, but you know, today, again, Logan with four walks, you with three hits, Dylan with three, and Johnny some really good bats there. I mean, what does it say about the length of this lineup when you're getting so much production from the bottom half?
I mean, it's big time. Like I said before, I mean, 1 through 9, I think we're a complete offense, and I think it really shows. I mean, I'd say, I mean, bottom half picks up the front half, and the front half picks up the bottom every game, and that's what we need to go by.
Steph?
What's it like when, you know, for you, Connor, for guys in front of you, you know, Logan gets four walks, Dakota gets intentionally walked three times, just, you know, what's kind of your approach there of, you know, knowing those guys are going to get on base for you and you have a chance to really drive in some runs?
I mean, just take advantage of it. I mean, if they're getting on for me, it's a big advantage to me. I get to, you know, get those stats for them, but they're doing their job for me, and it's awesome.
Doug?
Dylan, Coach mentioned the play when you threw to third for the tag. Said it was a very poised play for a freshman. Do you remember anything about that? Thinking about it, or just it's just instinct?
No, that's something that, like, anytime the guy's on second, I'm like, you know, I tell Loco, I'm like, hey, dude, ball this way. You know, I'm coming to you. It's something, you know, I mean, we practice it. It is, you know, it's just a baseball play. Like, honestly, I don't think much of it. It's just, you know, it's common sense to me. Like, the guy's right there, just over there. So, yeah.
Steve?
Yeah, this time last year, Logan was at Memphis and you were getting ready for prom, and now you guys are out there playing errorless baseball a lot. But how in the world have you guys developed such a chemistry out there that there never seems to be any miscommunication, you guys kind of bumping into each other or anything like that? So how has that relationship kind of come to be?
I think it's just like we both have so much trust in each other. And, I mean, it's every day, like, that's the guy I'm beside, you know, like, he's, you know, right next to me in the locker room. You know, we're constantly having baseball talk, or, you know, and sometimes it's not even baseball talk, you know, it might be like what happened last week or whatever. And, you know, it's more of like it's just that whole brotherhood, and I feel like the whole team's that way. Like, honestly, I could go to any of the guys in that locker room, and it's just something I've never had before. It's awesome.
Steph?
Connor, we've seen you obviously start games, pinch hit, come off the bench sometimes. I guess, how do you kind of stay locked in, you know, depending on what role you're given on a given day?
Just take advantage of every opportunity I get. I mean, stay ready is a big thing in the clubhouse for everybody. And, I mean, when you get in there, it's your time to shine. So, I mean, it's really just take it day by day and take advantage of everything you get.
Steve?
Kind of your parts program last year, going down to Biloxi, I know it feels like a home game because it's such a partisan crowd, but how cool is it to go on the road in the home state of Mississippi State and have the fans that maybe don't get to see you that often have a chance to come out and pack a ballpark for you?
I mean, it's awesome. You go play in a different place, and it's maroon and white everywhere. I mean, it's nothing like it in the country, and we have the best fans. So, I mean, it's a great time, and, I mean, you get to play ball in front of fans that aren't here all the time, so it's great.
All right. Robbie, you got one?
Yeah. I guess for Connor, since you've kind of experienced this before, Coach had mentioned this is kind of y'all spring break, and you handle it professionally kind of this week because you don't go to class and all that. I mean, what's that experience like for you? What's y'all's kind of daily routine leading up to these ball games?
I mean, it doesn't change much. I mean, you obviously don't have classes, which is great. But I mean, it's like you're professional for a week, like you said. So, I mean, it's it's a great time to really bond with your teammates, play ball, and just have fun.
Coach,